What if, rather than forcing and dominating nature, humankind recognized the miraculous benefits that nature provides, an acknowledgement that we are part of the system rather than above it? What if our urban infrastructure could provide more than a singular design solution, but a host of additional social, environmental, and economic benefits? So in an untouched natural system, when precipitation falls, some of the water hits leaf surfaces where it is evaporated to the atmosphere as water vapor. Some of the water also reaches the ground where it is absorbed by plants and through evapotranspiration released to the atmosphere again as water vapor or oxygen. And some of this water also infiltrates through the soils, basically completing the natural water cycle. So unlike natural landscapes, urban areas are covered with many solid impervious surfaces, creating increased volumes of stormwater runoff. Conventionally, stormwater has been managed through gray infrastructure. However, this linear end of pipe type thinking disconnects the dynamic processes that nature provides, such as balance, buffering, and adaptive capacity. So what should we be doing? Enabling nature to do what nature does best. Recently, I was fortunate enough to be part of an innovative project that asked these kinds of questions and sought an alternative solution to shift away from a traditional stormwater design to an innovative green project. When approached by the Bow River Basin Council, our regional watershed collaborative, and Source to Source, a green infrastructure consultant, about partnering on a unique stormwater project, we said it was an opportunity we didn't want to miss. The stars aligned for this project as we were just finalizing the redevelopment of our operations center, which consists of a public works yard and several new LEED Gold certified buildings. The site was perfect for this project. It was adjacent to our river, a mature riparian forest, and the site needed a TLC. The site is a half hectare bioretention bed with two connecting overland drainage swales, which are all also vegetated. Both are constructed with a soil profile designed to mimic that of a mature forest floor, alive with rotting wood debris, compost, and soil microorganisms. After a storm event, water from the site is sent to the bioretention area, where within about 48 hours, it is either absorbed by the plants and released to the atmosphere through transpiration or through infiltration into the ground into the receiving aquifer. Sounds familiar, right? The basic natural cycle. In Alberta, bioretention systems have received a bit of a bad reputation recently. Historically, they've been built with native vegetation with shallow roots. Over time, those soil pores tended to get filled with soil fines, often leading to reduced infiltration rates, many then stating within 5 years, the systems simply don't work. The Okotoks system's a little bit different because it uses native plants, grasses as well, but mostly trees and shrubs that have rigorous root growth. And the rigorous root growth does two things. It does water quality improvement and also continuous infiltration. So seasonally, those roots grow out in the summer, and in the winter they die back, creating spaces in the soil. It's basically a dynamic system, like a hand massaging the soil, constantly creating new channels. Additionally, through the biogeochemical interactions which occur within the rhizosphere, which is a small area between a root and the soil, where there's actual chemical interactions that happen between root secretions, and soil microorganisms actually clean the water, and it can remove different types of contaminants. So while the demonstration site was the initial focus of the project, additional opportunities continue to spring up. We actually discovered a farmer's scrap heap that had been on the site for probably 100 years, and underneath they had buried full trees. I mean, these were huge trees, and it was the perfect material for the creation of the bioretention site. Early in the process, the project team was consulted by the University of Calgary and the University of Victoria and the City of Calgary about integrating a post-secondary research facility onto the site. And now the university is also researching what specific types of plants work best for those chemical interactions, and also which soil profiles work best for those infiltration rates. And we are now also researching the ability of these same plants and soils to also digest methane, which will be used for future landfill applications. This same facility is being replicated in Victoria, so we're getting a Western Canada level of research. We decided to partner with EPCOR to integrate an education facility onto the site. We felt that learning about the project was as important as the project itself. Many additional benefits beyond the basic stormwater design mitigation were achieved. Climate change adaptation to extreme events such as drought and flood, enhanced biodiversity, improved water quality, and improved aesthetics. Now is the time for humans to step off our pedestal and rejoin the natural world. Remember, eco, not ego. Often nature does it best. Thank you.